School of Athens by Raphael Sanzio, Deconstructing the Art. Art historians have suggested that nearly every great Greek philosopher can be found within the painting, but determining who is depicted is challenging because Raphael made no notes nor designations, and there are no historical documents to explain the painting. Raphael invented a system of iconography which alluded to various philosophers. For example, while the figure of Socrates is immediately recognizable from classical sculptural examples, the depiction of alleged philosopher Epicurus is far removed from the standard depictions of the day. Despite these inconsistencies, there is widespread agreement onto the identities of certain figures within the painting, and therefore an educated hypothesis can be made as to the identities of the remaining figures. In the center of the fresco stands Plato with his student Aristotle to his right. Plato is depicted as an old, gray, wise-looking man, and this is contrasted by Aristotle, positioned slightly ahead of him, rendered as a mature, handsome man, well-dressed and decorated in gold. Plato's gesture is vertical, upwards along the picture plane, into the beautiful vault above. This upward motion represents his theory of forms and an emphasis on universals. Aristotle, on the horizontal plane, at right angles, is initiating a powerful flow of space towards the viewers. He motions, indicating his strong empiricist views and an emphasis on the particular. There are two sculptures in the background. The one on the left, holding a lyre, historians have identified as Apollo, the Greek god of the sun, archery, and music. The sculpture on the right is Athena, goddess of wisdom, in her Roman guise as Minerva.